Durham consigned Hampshire to the second division as they wrapped up victory on the final day in Southampton. Hampshire's task was clear going into day four, a win or prepare for life in Division 2 next season. Hampshire resumed on 176 for 7, an overall lead of 226. The hosts needed to produce one of their best performances of the season if they were to stay up, but things were off to a bad start when Crane was caught by Borthwick off Pringle for 1 off just the third ball of the day. McManus chose to sweep to counteract the spin of Pringle, and it was a strategy that worked, forcing the bowler to first change his line and then to change his own strategy by coming around the wicket. However, it was this change that eventually brought the wicket. McManus caught down the leg side off Pringle for 67. Weil and Berg put on 27 for the 10th wicket before Hampshire declared on 245 for 9, Pringle finishing with figures of 7 for 107. 296 was the target for Durham, Hampshire leaving themselves 2.5 sessions to bowl their visitors out. Early wickets were at a premium for Hampshire, but openers Stoneman and Jennings were having none of it, putting on 41 without loss to take the visitors through to lunch. Jennings and Stoneman continued to frustrate Hampshire after the break as their opening stand reached 75. But there's where it would stop as Hampshire finally had a wicket, Crane getting one to turn sharply and keep low to trap Jennings LBW for 25. Hampshire having to wait a long time for the finger to go up. Borthwick was the new man in and he joined Stoneman in punishing the Hampshire attack as batting conditions continued to improve in the afternoon session. Hampshire's season was slipping away with every wicketless over that passed, and Durham went to tee on 149 for 1, meaning Hampshire had the near impossible task of taking 9 wickets in the evening session to win the match and avoid relegation. Stoneman and Borthwick continued to heap the misery on Hampshire in the evening session as their chances of survival faded away. Stoneman passed 100 as the pair put on 162 for the second wicket. Crane and Dawson picked up a couple of late wickets, but it was too little too late for Hampshire as Durham wrapped up the win by 6 wickets, consigning Hampshire to Division 2 next season. It was a valiant effort from Hampshire, who gave it everything in this final do-or-die match. They gave themselves every chance with the bat, but couldn't quite take the wickets needed to finish off the match. Durham finished the season with back-to-back wins to lift them to 4th in the table, and they'll take lots of positives from the end of their 2016 campaign as they look to build towards a title challenge in 2017.